Welcome to the first episode of Star Trek Online Lore, where I'll talk about the lore behind the game and what came before in the different series and movies, and from time to time, I may have a rant or two. Most importantly, I should mention these little tidbits of information. This podcast will be using video clips from Star Trek The Animated Series, produced by Filmation in 1973 and created by Gene Roddenberry as a continuation of the original series and aired on NBC on Saturday mornings, and Deep Space Nine, which was produced in 1993 to 1999 and was created by Rick Berman and Michael Piller and was produced by Paramount Television. There's also video from Star Trek Online, which is licensed to Cryptic Studios by CBS. All film is used under fair use laws and is not to be used for profit, merely entertainment, as this podcast takes a closer look at the lore and the different aspects of Star Trek, especially in Star Trek Online. Our first episode explores the Ferassin, and in particular, their relationship to the Kzinti.
We won't have any trouble digging for it. In this low pressure, the ice should boil as soon as the phasers melted.
Ah, the Kzinti, the feline species of the Star Trek The Animated Series episode, The Slaver Weapon. Written by Larry Niven, this episode gave us the first glimpse of the Kzinti and speculation if they were related to one other feline species called the Kashians. The first Kashian to make an appearance in Star Trek was in the animated series and in the episode The Survivor, with communications officer Maress, voiced by Major Barrett Roddenberry. For years, it was always a popular species that was never seen in any of the Star Trek series. The only other appearance was an admiral in Star Trek The Voyage Home, as the character was seen speaking to an Andorian in the background at Admiral Kirk's trial. But there has always been issues with representing these two species in Star Trek, and it has nothing to do with the makeup difficulties and everything to do with a long-standing copyright battle. You see, Larry Niven wrote the Kzinti in his Known Space series, originally introduced in Niven's story The Warriors in 1966 and The Soft Weapon in 1967, they appeared in the Niven-written Slaver Weapon in the 1973 animated series. But thanks to copyright issues, the Kzinn and even the Kashians were not allowed to be used in any other Star Trek merchandise for a very long time. Even though there was a possible fifth season of Enterprise, which would in fact focus on the Kzinti and the Kashians, that never came to light thanks to her cancellation after season 4. And in the game Star Trek Online, instead of using the Kzinti for the feline race allied with the Klingons, the name Ferassin was used instead, and a completely different backstory evolved. So what exactly are the changes? Let's take a look.
Identify yourself. Lieutenant Sulu of the Starfleet vessel Enterprise. This is First Officer Spock.
You're a Vulcan. I feel no pressing need to talk to an eater of roots and leaves. Humans, at least, are omnivorous. I am Chuffed Captain. You are prisoners aboard the privateer Traitor's Claw, a stolen police vessel.
In the animated series, we're given a long speech from Spock, which is a grand amount of exposition explaining the backstory of the Kzinti. We're also informed, thanks to Sulu, that the Kzinti aren't supposed to have weapons, except for police vehicles due to a treaty signed between the Kzinti and most likely Earth. But the basics state that the Kzinti are a violent species whose women are nothing better than animals, and they distrust anyone who is a vegetarian. They're also mind readers, and those who practice this are prone to neurosis and antisocial behavior. The Kzinti evolved from a plains-hunting species that lived on a colder, drier planet than Earth. Thanks to the Jakotai, the Kzinti became a species of mercenaries when the alien species first made contact with a primitive Kzinti tribe. Kzinti are a male-driven species that does not value women, treating them no less than animals, and they do not trust any species who is vegetarian, such as what Chuffed Captain says to Spock in the animated series, claiming all Vulcans are eaters of roots and leaves. In a nutshell, the Kzinti right away are seen as bad guys. They live in a warlike, patriarchal, and misogynistic society, so the Ferassin, which became the species replacement in Star Trek Online, must be exactly like this, right?
Ah! Nothing like this has ever been found. We are the only ones who have it. Look at it, human. This weapon may well mean the end of mankind.
Not exactly. As it states at the Star Trek Online Wiki, The Foracin and the Cations actually lived together until 800 years ago, when Cations decided to experiment with genetic augmentation. We saw how well that went over with human beings. Foracin are the result of that, and instead of the species being the obviously villainous Kzinti, they actually can draw some sympathy for what happened to them. Plus, it doesn't make the Cations look like a completely flawless species. They have their faults, just like any other race in the Star Trek universe. This actually makes a better characterization of the species that could be villainous in the Star Trek universe. The Foracin can draw much more empathy as being rejected augments than just a species that happens to be an enemy of the Cations. Its backstory actually explains why, and suddenly things aren't so black and white. Maybe, just maybe, the Foracin have a much deeper backstory than before. Naturally, we get more of a backstory of the Kzinti in Larry Niven's Known Space, but thanks to copyright and legalese, this cannot be a part of Star Trek.
This is the Traitor's Claw calling Mr. Sulu. We have the female prisoner. Will you bargain, or must we take harsh action? It will not be pleasant for her.
Naturally, the Kzinti have been snuck into Star Trek in one way, shape, or form more than once. Probably one of the most interesting was in the Deep Space Nine episode, The Adversary, which was a Season 3 episode. In it, newly promoted Captain Sisko has to take the Defiant into a sector of space where the Zenkethi reside and show the flag in order to prevent war. As it turns out, the ambassador who initiated the mission was a changeling. The Zenkethi are briefly mentioned again in By Inferno's Light and in Paradise Lost.
Those pips look good on you, Captain. Though, to be honest, I'm not really here for the ceremony.
I had that feeling. What can I do for you?
Our intelligence reports indicate there's been a coup d'etat on the Zenkethi homeworld.
I doubt anyone is going to miss the Autark.
I know I won't. Unfortunately, it's too early to tell who's in control. But we don't want to take any chances. We need to remind the Zenkethi that the Federation is committed to protecting our colonies near their border.
You want to show the flag?
Exactly.
We had an incredible opportunity that was completely lost when Enterprise was canceled. It was revealed that Season 5 of Enterprise would feature the Kzinti and the Cations. Sadly, we never got to see any of this. To that end, the Foracin do not appear to have the same misogynistic background as the Kzinti do. Women can be captains of ships, women can be scientists, and women can be diplomats and traders. Whether or not that extends to aspects of the government, we're never really shown. But at least with the Foracin, they are similar to the Kzinti in a way, but much more similar to the Cations as they are an augmented species. So what are the major differences between Foracin and Cation races? Well, Foracin are slightly larger, having more muscle mass. They have more pronounced teeth. The Foracins feel they are superior to the Cations and relish the opportunity to prove this fact in combat. Their society is not patriarchal as the Kzinti's is, but they are social in a way that they create clans based loosely on related family groups who band together to help the whole and to defend their homes and to seek conquest. This means it's completely likely that encountering a ship in deep space captained by a Foracin might very well mean that his or her entire family group is on that ship. Loyalty is highly praised among Foracin, though betrayal is not uncommon. Well, thanks for joining me in this first episode, and if you want to leave a comment, do so in the comments below. Maybe there's some stuff that I should add into this, and we'll see about putting some more in next episode. Maybe I'll read some in the next episode. You never know what goes on. I'll post links in the section below which lead to different articles on the Kzinti and the Foracin. And if you're traveling the galaxy in Star Trek Online, look for me at Hawk Scream, that's HawkScream. One of my main characters is Rhett Nevek, a Foracin tactical officer, and another is Mia T'Chall, a Federation Cation tactical officer. So if you see me in game, send me a tell or a whisper, and or even wave hello, and I'll wave hello back. Until next time, let's continue boldly going.